What's up everyone, welcome back to the channel. In this video, I'm going to show you a quick technique on how you can essentially look into the future or get x-ray vision and see exactly where your project is going to lay out on your waste board. You won't be wasting extra painter's tape and glue, and you won't be wasting extra material. You'll be able to get the most out of every piece that you have in your shop, so stick around. If you check out my waste board here, it is pretty clean. I've had this same board in this condition for I'd say probably about 4 or 5 months now. I had this originally set up, and when I would do any sort of cutting, I would just use my clamps and I would clamp my project board directly down to my waste board. But then as you start cutting through your waste board, it starts getting chewed up and it looks bad. Plus you don't always then get a good register on your elevation. If there's pits or if there's some pieces fraying up from this waste board, you won't get a true Z measurement all the way across here. So anytime I'm cutting, I like to use a sacrificial waste board. I've got large ones like this one here. And then I've got smaller ones like this. This one is one that I use to cut coasters. It's basically just a piece of 1/4 inch MDF. And I tape on my coasters there with blue tape and CA glue. And then I can cut through these. What's great about this is if you look at it, these coasters always end up in the same spot every time. So what I can do is while I'm trying to cut these out of a solid piece of oak, when I lay down my painter's tape, I can put the glue just where I know there's going to be a coaster. And when I secure my board, I know that as I cut through that wood, my coasters will not come loose. Rather than taking the glue, squeezing out a full line, you can do that. So what I did was I took this concept and I do it on a larger scale for a larger product. If you take a look at this project board I got set up here, I've got several pieces that I'm going to need to cut all the way through. Now, in order to keep all these pieces secure, you can do this one of two ways. You can use the tab function. So if I click on one of these and I come over to cut, if you scroll down here, it'll say use tabs. So if I click use tabs, and I zoom way in on that particular piece, and I highlight it. See if I can get you a little bit closer here. So you can see this yellow piece right here. That's a tab right there. I look right there, there's a tab right there. Now you can scroll over these tabs and you can move them to a better location, such as on the outside of a tooth right here. But once you finish cutting this thing all the way through, now you're going to have all these tabs to contend with. So what you're going to have to do, you're going to have to flip your board over, take a razor knife or something, cut through that tab, and then bring that over to your router table and flush those up with a flush trim bit. It's just extra steps, and I do not like using tabs at all. So I always highlight it. I don't want any tabs being used anywhere. So that presents a problem. That means all this is going to end up being loose. So in order to combat that, you could put down your painter's tape and CA glue. But now if you're looking at this whole project here on this left side, this board is 30 inches long, 15 inches high. It's going to be a nightmare trying to figure out exactly where to put the glue and tape, exactly where to have it, especially on these two pieces right here. These three squares, I should call them rectangles, are going to be cut out all the way through. So you would have to have a piece of tape there and there, a couple pieces holding on to these, maybe one. So it's kind of a nightmare. So I've come up with a solution to better be able to tell myself where all these pieces are. And what I do is I take my file that I'm ready to cut, the actual finished product. I will highlight this whole thing and I will change my depth to very minimal. I'm going to call it 0.05. That's just under a 16th of an inch. So if you come over here and you look at the preview screen, that's going to cut very minimal. Just enough to give me some lines to show me where I need to put my glue and tape. Then once I'm ready to set my actual workpiece, I can just put glue in these zones on the pieces that I know I want to hold down. And that way I don't have to deal with tabs. So I'm going to go through and I'm going to run this file just like this, and then I'll show you what I got. So the file is finished running, and as you can see, I've got all my pieces here, and now I know exactly where I want to put the tape. When I put down my tape and my glue, I will be able to secure all these pieces, especially these smaller ones that I'm afraid of coming loose. I am cutting this file with a 16th inch bit, so it is very fragile. So if any of these come loose or shift at all, it will definitely break that bit. But now that I've got these score lines in here, I will put down my tape and glue, and I will bring it back when I'm done with that. So I've got my masking tape down on all these pieces that I know are going to end up coming loose. I've already added my tape to the back of my actual workpiece, which is just some quarter inch Baltic birch plywood. And now I'm gonna add my CA glue. This glue right here is the stuff that I love to use. It's by Starbond. If you guys are interested in some of this stuff, you can go to their website and use code SJS10. You can get 10% off your purchase and I will get a small commission. So it's a win-win. Okay, so here's the file. You can see it cut very clean. All of my pieces stayed exactly where I needed them to. They didn't break free and break my bit or get caught up. Sometimes, even if they don't break the bit, they will get chunks taken out of them simply because they move into the path of the spinning bit. But if you look at it real close here, you can see these stay exactly where I need them to stay. Because of that glue and tape, you can peel that off. You don't have to cut any tabs. You don't have to do anything. There you go. So if you run your file at a very shallow depth first, you will know exactly where to put your tape. And then you can tape it and all your pieces will stay put. You can see right there in the middle of that cutout, there's that piece of tape. So if you guys enjoyed this, give me a thumbs up and a subscribe. And until next time, take it easy.